गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द नेक्स्ट सेशन ऑफ ज्योमेट्री एंड मेंसुरेशन, दैट इज अवर सेशन नंबर 4. माई सेल्फ दिनेश मिंगलानी. दीज सेशंस आर वेरी हेल्पफुल फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स हु आर गोइंग फॉर एसएससी प्री एंड मेंस एग्जामिनेशन, एज वेल एज टू दो स्टूडेंट्स हु आर गोइंग फॉर प्रिपरेशन ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट जॉब्स. लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन ऑफ दिस सेशन. ए सॉलिड इज हेमिस्फेरिकल एट द बॉटम एंड कोनिकल अबव, राइट? इफ द सर्फेस एरिया ऑफ टू पार्ट्स आर इक्वल, what is the ratio of the radius to the height of the conical part? When I just try to have a look over the figure would be somewhere in this shape. Okay, this is the radius, and that is said to be h, and that is l. Here it is given that hemispherical and conical, right? When I talk about hemispherical, the surface area is 2 pi r square, because total is 4 pi r square. Here it is talking about the outer part, that is said to be 2 pi r square, right? And similarly, if I talk about a cone, that is pi r n, so I may say pi r into under root of r square plus h square. Okay, it is given that these two are equal. These two are equal, right? So what I can say? So here I can say that pi would be cancelled out, r would be cancelled out. So you may say 2 r equal to under root of r square plus h square, right? I have to find the ratio of r is to h. You may just try the options here. If I say my option is first one, it is 2, r is 2, and that is h, right? Here if I put that to be 1 and 3, so 9 and 1, 10 is not my answer. Similarly, if I take 1 and 1, that becomes 2, and here it is under root of 2, it's not my answer. If I say root 3 and 1, that would be 2 root 3, right? But here it should be 3 plus 1, 4, that is 2, it's not my answer. If I take my fourth one option, if I put r to be 1, that is 2, and here 1 plus 3, 4, under root 2, both are same. Here I can say answer to my question is fourth one, 1 ratio root 3, that becomes my answer. I hope the idea is clear. Bahut simple hota hai question. Don't be confused with the statements. Just draw a figure, right? And then take the help of the options, because that are the real friends of yours in order to get these type of questions. Let us have the second question here. Just try to read the information. Base of a right prism is an equilateral triangle of side 6. Volume is 108 root 3. We have to find the height, right? We know that volume of the prism is area of the base into height. That is our formula. Now, base is equilateral, root 3 by 4 into a square into height. This is equal to 108 root 3. Root 3 is cancelled out. 36 will go on 3, height is equal to 12, right? Here I can say answer to my question is fourth one, 12 centimeter becomes my answer, right? Now it's very important for us to have all the formulas in our mind, area of the base into height. Let us have the next question here. It is given that perimeter of a triangle, base of a right prism is 15 centimeter and the radius of in circle is 3, right? We know that if the volume is this one, we have to find height. Same formula we have to apply. That is area of the base into height is equal to volume, right? Here we are concerned with area of the base. Perimeter is given as well as in radius is given, right? We know that r into s is equal to area of the triangle, right? Now r is said to be in radius, that is given to us 3. S is semi-perimeter. Here perimeter is given, let us take it as 15 by 2. So from here I can say that is my area. Area of the base into height equal to 270, right? 15, 3, 45, it will go on 6. From here I can say height is said to be 12, right? Here answer to my question is fourth one, 12 centimeter is my answer. Now in this question we have used two direct formulas here. First one is that is volume of a prism, and the second formula that we have used, that is in radius and semi-perimeter, means we know that area of a triangle is always equal to in radius into semi perimeter. R into S is equal to area of the triangle. Let us have a look over the next question here. What is given in the next question is, it is given that a semicircular sheet of metal of diameter 28 centimeter is bent into an open conical cup, right? The depth of the cup is approximately. It means somewhere we have to find the height of the cup, right? And it is given that the diameter is 28 and it is semicircular. What I can say that when I convert it into the conical shape, here I can say this radius, that is 14, it becomes the slant height, right? And the next thing we can say, because it was semicircle earlier, it means its circumference was pi r, pi into 14. If I take r to be here, so that becomes the semi-perimeter of the base, right? So I can say r is said to be 7. Okay, I have to find the depth, means that height I have to find out. Apply Pythagoras, that is 14 square minus 7 square. Right, I can say 7 square as common outside, right? Inside I will get 2 square minus 1, that is 3. So 7 into 1.732, just multiply, right? From that we can get an approximate value. When I say 7 into 7 to 14, 4 carry 1, 21 and 1, 22 2 carry 2, 49 to 51 1 carry 5, 12, right? My approximate answer is 12. Here I can say second is my answer. Now this question is a simple question in which we have to convert a semicircle into a cone, right? And for better understanding of these concepts, you may watch my sessions on my YouTube channel in which I have taken the basic aspect of three-dimensional geometry. There you may find it. But here it's a very simple thing, that is approximately 12 centimeter. Let us have the next question here. It is given that radius and height of a cone are in the ratio 4:3, ratio of the curved surface area to total surface area, right? Let us say the radius is 4 and height is 3. Radius is 4 and height is 3. So I may say here that slant height is said to be 5, applying Pythagoras. Curved surface area, that is pi r l, right, is to total surface area, we can say that pi r into r plus l, that is 9. Pi would be cancelled out, that is cancelled out. So I may say 5:9. Here first is my answer. So if I have to find out the ratio of the curved surface area to total surface area, your answer is said to be 5:9. Let us have the next question here. The diameter of a cylinder is 7 cm and height is 16. Right? The diameter is 7, it means radius is 7/2, height is 16. The lateral surface area of the cylinder, you know that lateral surface area is 2 pi r into h into 16, right? Just solve it. 2 will cancel out, 22 into 16, so 16 to 32, 2, 3, 35, so I can say that is said to be 352 square centimeter. That becomes my answer. Here I can say lateral surface area of the cylinder is first one, 352 square centimeter. Let us have the next question here. The length of a chord of a circle at a distance of 12 centimeter from the center is 10, right? Means the length of a chord of a circle at a distance of 12 centimeter from the center is 10. It means, let us say this is the length of the chord is 10, right? And at a distance of 12 from the center, this is 12. This would be 5. We have to find the radius, that would be 13. By applying Pythagoras, we know that from the center of the circle, if we draw a perpendicular on the chord, it divides it equally, right? It means it is 5. Now by applying Pythagoras, I can say this is 13. So here we can say the radius is 13 and I have to find the diameter. My answer is 26. Third becomes my answer. Let us have the next question here. Area of the incircle of an equilateral triangle with side 6, right? We know that in radius formula is a by 2 root 3, right? So I can say in radius is 6 by 2 root 3, or that would be taken as 3 by root 3, or finally I can say root 3. Now area is pi r square, pi into r square, that is 3. Hence I can say that is equal to 3 pi, fourth is my answer, because I have to find the area of the incircle. Let us have the next question. Circumradius of an equilateral triangle be 10. What is the measure of the inradius? We know that in equilateral triangle, the ratio of the circumradius to inradius is 2:1. Or we can say inradius is always half of the circumradius. Hence, inradius is said to be 5. Let us have the next question. The length of a room floor exceeds its breadth by 20. If I say breadth to be x, length would be x plus 20. Area of the floor remains unaltered when length is decreased by 10. It means length become x plus 10, but breadth increased by 5. I can say that is x plus 5, right? So here in the answer, we have to find out what is the area. So what I can say, the product of these two is same, that is x square plus 20x is same as to x square, right, plus 15x plus 50. That is according to the question, because area is length into breadth, area is length into breadth, right? This is cancelled out, so I can say 5x equal to 50, x equal to 10. Now this is 10, this is 30, right? What I have to find out area of the floor, 10 into 30, 300 square meter becomes my answer. Hence, I can say answer is third one, 300 square meter. Let us have the next question here. Right angle isosceles triangle is inscribed in a semicircle of radius 7. Okay, so what the figure we have, it's a semicircle. Because the triangle is a right angle triangle, it means one hypotenuse must be diameter. Because that must be a 90 degree, otherwise it's impossible. Right, so what I have to find out, area enclosed, it's a isosceles, both sides are equal. This is 14, here we can say this is 14 by root 2. And this is 14 by root 2. Now area of the triangle is half into base into height. 14 by root 2 into 14 by root 2. Right. 2 will go on 7. 2 will go on 7. I can say that is 49. I have to find the area outside of the triangle. Right. For that we have to find the area of the semicircle. That is pi r square by 2. Right. 2 will go on 11. 7 cancel out 77. Now 77 minus 49. My answer is said to be 28, right? Hence I can say second is my answer. Now in this question, important point for you to understand is, when we talk about a right angle isosceles triangle in a semicircle, so this is the correct position for that. Okay, the next question is, what is the area of a triangle having a perimeter 32, one side is 11 and the difference of the other two is 5, right? Perimeter is 32, it means sum of the remaining must be 21. I may say a plus b is 21 and the difference is 5. A minus b is 5. Just solve it. From here I can say a equal to 13 and b equal to 8. Right. Now my sides are 13, 8 and 11. I have to find the area. We will apply here the Hero's formula. S 13, that is 32 is given. S is 16. Under root of S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C. Right. Now what I can say, I may take here 8 would be taken as common. Inside I will get it as 3 into 5, 30. So here I can say area is said to be 8 root 30 square centimeter. First becomes my answer. Right. Now these are very simple questions. Only what is expected from you here is just all formulas in your mind and then solving it. Radius of two circles are 5 and 3. The distance between their centers is 24. Length of the transverse common tangent. Right. In my sessions of circles, I told you about transverse common tangent. Here the formula is C1 C2 whole square minus R1 plus R2 square. That is the formula for transverse common tangent. If you have to take direct common tangent, it should be R1 minus R2 square. Right. Now what I can say, the distance between their centers 24 square 576 minus 5 plus 3 8, 8 square 64. That I can say just subtract it 2, 17 6 9 492. Right. Now I just try to make the factors. So what I can say that would be taken as, I may just make the factors, whether it's a multiple of 4, yes, 4 into, I'm getting to be 123. Right. So here my answer should be that one. Let us have the look at the option. Somewhere we have committed a mistake. The radius of two circles is 5 and 3. Right. So that we can say that is said to be C1, C2. That is 576. Right. Minus R1 plus R2. That we can say 8, 64. Right. If I subtract it, 6, 4. Sorry. Here it should be 512. That we have committed a mistake here. 512. Okay. Now when I talk about 512, that is 2 raised to power 9. Right. So what I can say, 2 raised to power 4 would be outside. Inside I am getting to be 2. The answer is 16 root 2. That becomes my answer. Right. Mistake is here. When we subtract it, that is 512. Let us have the next question. Volume of a right circular cone is 1232 and its vertical height is 24. Find the curved surface area. Right. When volume is given, height is given, I can find the radius. We know that 1 by 3 into pi into r square into h equal to 1232. Right, just solve it. 3 will go on 8. Now if I just try to cancel it at 8, 8 will go on 1. 43, 8 will go on 5. Right, 8 will go on 1. 43, 5 and then 4. 22 sevens are right. That I can say. Now I can say that r square equal to 49. That we have r equal to 7. Now r is 7 and height is 24. By applying Pythagoras, I can say l is said to be 25. Right. Now curved surface area pi r l. तो एल कैंसल आउट, 22 इंटू 25 5005, 50 एंड 555, माय आंसर इज सेट टू बी 550, सेकंड इज माय आंसर. तो हियर आई कैन से कर्व सरफेस एरिया सेट टू बी 550 स्क्वायर सेंटीमीटर, सेकंड बिकम्स माय आंसर. लेट अस हैव द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. वॉल्यूम ऑफ ए सॉलिड हेमिस्फीयर इज 19404, द टोटल सर्फेस एरिया इज राइट. व्हाट आई कैन से वॉल्यूम फॉर्मूला इज, बिकॉज सॉलिड हेमिस्फीयर 4/3 पाई आर क्यू राइट, दिस इज इक्वल टू 19404. ओके आई जस्ट ट्राई टू सिंप्लीफाई, आई नो दैट फर्स्ट कैंसिल इट ऑन 4, 4 16 34 8 35 देन 51 राइट. नाउ व्हेन आई लुक एट दिस पार्ट इट शुड बी कैंसिल्ड ऑन 11, बिकॉज 189459 11 विल गो ऑन 2, 11 विल गो ऑन 4, दैट इज सेट टू बी 44 राइट. देन वी हैव 44 45 4 एंड 11. ओके तो व्हाट आई एम गेटिंग हियर, हियर आई कैन से दैट आर क्यूब is set to be, because when I cancel it on 4, 4, 4, 16, right, 34, 4, 8, 32, 5, right, that value you have. Okay, now R cube would be taken as 441 into 3 into 7 divided by 2, that you are getting here, right. Solid hemisphere, it's a hemisphere, it should be 2 by 3, so that 2 would not be there, right. So the, my, it should be, that is there. Okay, now I know that R cube is 21 cube, R is said to be 21. Now we have to find the total surface area. For a hemisphere, total surface area is said to be 3 pi r square. Now just put your formula, 3 into 22 into 7 into r square, 21 into 21, right, 7 will go on 3, just solve it, that's your answer, right. So I may say 3 3 is 9, so 9 into 22, you may say that is 198 into 21, just multiply, that's your answer, that is said to be total surface area of the hemisphere. Now questions are simple, you are fast calculations, that's the requirement for that, and just understanding of the question, with that you can easily answer it, right. A solid hemisphere is radius 11, curved surface area, right. I know that in a hemisphere curved surface area is 2 pi r square. Okay, now the radius is 11, I may say that is 2 pi r square, 11 into 11, so that is 121, or I may say 11, 11, 11, 1331 into 4 by 7. Now it is easy for you to answer, you can just multiply by 4, 4, 3, 12 to carry 1, 12 and 1, 13, 3 carry 1, 5 divided by 7. Okay, so I here can say 7, 7, 49, 3rd is my answer, because in all other options, I am getting value to be more than that, so hence I can say 3rd is my answer, 760.57. Length of each median of an equilateral triangle is 6 root 3, the perimeter of the triangle. We know that in equilateral triangle, median is simply the height of the triangle. So we know that the formula is root 3 by 2a equal to 6 root 3. I can say a is said to be 12. Perimeter is said to be 36. That becomes my answer. We know that in equilateral triangle, medians, angle bisectors, perpendicular bisectors and altitude, all four are the same thing. So here I can say answer is said to be 36. The next question here is, a cone and a hemisphere stand on equal base and have the same height. What is the ratio of their whole surface area? Right. Now, what I can say, cone, whole surface area is said to be pi r into r plus l. So I may say r plus, because here it is given that the radius and the height are the same. You can say that that is root 2 r, so r plus root 2 into r, that you have. And when I talk about that hemisphere, that is 3 pi r square, that you have. Okay, now pi would be cancelled out, r would be taken as common, r square would be cancelled out, so 1 plus root 2 is to 3, right. So here my answer is said to be first one, 1 plus root 2 is to 3. Why? Because in this question, because it is given that their heights are same, right, it means if their heights are same, because we know that hemisphere height is the radius, okay, and in the cone if height is equal to radius, so it's very easy for us to for finding the slant height in the terms of r. Two cubes of side 6 are kept side by side to form a rectangular parallelopipe. Now when we look at this figure, parallelopipe, generally that is same as to a cuboid, area of the whole surface area of the rectangular parallelopipe is, right. So what I can say, if two cubes of 6 are kept aside, then let us have a figure here, otherwise you can also think in your mind, 6, 6, this is 6 and height is 6, that is 12, right. What I can say, अब वी हैव टू फाइंड द टोटल सरफेस एरिया ट्वाइस ऑफ एल बी प्लस बी एच प्लस एच एल राइट दैट इज 144 प्लस 36 180 इंटू 2 तो हियर आई कैन से टोटल सरफेस एरिया इज सेट टू बी 360 एज पर टू द क्वेश्चन सेकेंड बिकम्स माई आंसर बिकॉज when two cubes are formed in such a way, the figure made by the joining this will become a cuboid, right? And here I can say answer is 360. Let us have the next question here. A solid sphere of 6 cm diameter is melted and recast into 8 solid spheres of equal volume. What is the radius of the smaller, right? So what I can say, diameter is 6. So here I can say radius is 3. Volume is 4 by 3 pi R cube, 3 into 3 into 3, right? Now, this is equal to 8 into 4 by 3 pi R cube. I have to find radius. 4 pi by 3 would be cancelled out, okay? Now, that would be there. So, R cube would be said to be 27 by 8 or R is said to be 3 by 2. So, I can say radius is said to be 1.5 centimeter. Here, I can say first is my answer because radius of the sphere is said to be 1.5, right? I hope you enjoyed the session, right? Now, in this session, the basic objective is to encourage you to have all the formulas in your mind and just when information comes to you, try to understand it and put it into the answering form, right? So you may send your feedback at my email ID legalbuddy@gmail.com. Do comment on that so that your comments is an encouraging factor for us. Or you may connect me on my Facebook @DineshMiglani. My WhatsApp number is 092-155-14435. Thank you very much.